Welcome to the Prayer Motivator Devotional Broadcast with Daniel White III. We are glad that you have joined us as Daniel White III motivates us and encourages us to simply just pray for the glory of God. Daniel White III is the national best-selling author of over 20 books. He has spoken in meetings across the United States and in over 25 foreign countries. He is the president of Gospel Light Society and Torch Ministries International. Now, here's your host, Daniel White III.
Welcome to another Prayer Motivator Devotional Broadcast, broadcast number 401. We do give God the glory, the praise, and the honor for allowing us to reach that milestone on yesterday. As always, it is so good to be with you today, to encourage you to pray. Today I would like to begin by sharing with you a poem titled Whisper a Prayer by Scott Lawrence. On tomorrow, Lord willing, we will hear a poem from my daughter, Daniela White. Whisper a prayer in the morning, just at the break of the day. Why fear the fight in your battle for right when you know he will lead all the way? Whisper a prayer at the noontime. Pause in the midst of the throng. Look unto him who can conquer all sin. In thy weakness, in him thou art strong. Whisper a prayer at the twilight, after the day's work is done. No other friend will prove true to the end like Christ Jesus, the crucified one. Somebody ought to say amen right where you are, even if you're on your treadmill. You ought to say praise the Lord. Our prayer A motivator passage from the Word of God today is Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 through 13, which reads, After this manner, therefore pray ye, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Allow me to share more with you today from Matthew Henry and his great commentary. Insights and important comments. He goes on to say, lastly, into all this we are taught to affix our amen, which means so be it. God's amen is a grant. His fiat is it shall be so. Our amen is only a summary desire. Our fiat is, let it be so. It is in the token of our desire and assurance to be heard that we may say amen. Amen refers to every petition going before and thus in compassion to our infirmities. We are taught to knit up the whole in one word and so to gather up in the general what we have lost and let slip in the particulars. It is good to conclude religious duties with some warmth and vigor, that we may go from them with a sweet savour upon our spirits. It was of old the practice of good people to say amen audibly at the end of every prayer, and it is a commendable practice, provided it be done with understanding, as the apostle directs, and uprightly, with life and liveliness and inward expressions, answerable to that outward expression of desire and confidence. Ladies and gentlemen, we will share more from the Word of God in our next broadcast, if the Lord should tarry His coming and we live. My personal encouragement to you today is this: you can pray to God anytime and anywhere. God will help you to pray with your family every day. I know He will, because in over 25 years of marriage and family life, I have never missed a day in prayer and family devotions with my own family. I did not do it in a perfunctory way, in a mechanical way. Something on the inside of me from God drove me to do it. And it is the single most important reason why our family of nine is still together and thriving in the work of the Lord, by the grace of God. Beloved, prayer is where the power is. Our prayer motivator quote today is from Chuck Smith. He said, "Prayer is the most important activity a born-again Christian can perform. It should head your list of priorities, for certainly the world around us desperately needs prayer. Prayer will open the door for God to do a glorious work in these last days. Prayer will stem the tide of evil." Our prayer motivator devotional today is part four of our series titled Miracles Today, continued from that Prince of Prayer, who's in heaven now, Dr. John R. Rice, the former editor of the Sword of the Lord magazine and the author of the best-selling book, Prayer, Asking and Receiving. He goes on to say, "Prophecy, that is, receiving divine revelations concerning the future, or at least divine revelations of knowledge not otherwise to be known, was prevalent throughout Bible times. Abel doubtless had divine revelations about the coming Savior and knew the meaning of a bloody sacrifice. Enoch was a prophet concerning even the second coming of Christ. Noah was plainly a prophet of God in foretelling the future of his descendants. God told Abimelech that Abraham was a prophet. Isaac, in blessing Jacob, and Esau proved that he had the gift of prophecy. Doubtless, even Laban and Bethuel and their family had this gift of prophecy too, as we see from Genesis chapter 24:60. Jacob and Joseph likewise had this same gift. Even during the sad period of the judges, there were prophets and prophetesses. David was a prophet, and the gift of prophecy certainly extended throughout Old Testament time, as far as we know, without any long interruption. Now, friend, it is time for us to pray. Holy Father God, we pray in the holy name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for allowing us to see this another beautiful day. Lord, we thank you for our Jewish friends as they celebrate this holiday on their calendar. Lord, we praise you and we thank you for your love, your mercy, and your grace. we individually, and I include all who are viewing right now, Lord, we confess our sins of disobedience, rebelliousness, and pride. Lord, we confess our sins to you. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive us, Lord, of our sins. Wash and cleanse us from all unrighteousness in the blood of Christ. Lord, fill us all afresh and anew this morning with the fullness and the power of your Holy Spirit, and lead us, guide us, and direct us throughout the remainder of this day in the way that you would have us to go. Lord, as we pray specifically over our prayer list, we pray, Lord, for all of your pastors, church leaders, missionaries, evangelists. We pray your life blessings upon them, your anointing upon them as they stand for you. And we pray for those, Lord, who are really helping your people. We also pray for the healing of every Christian marriage and family. We pray, Lord, for over 3 million people to come to know you as Savior. We pray, Lord, for the revival of the church. And Lord, we pray for the healing of this nation. Lord, we pray also that you would save and give leadership and wisdom to the president and to all governmental officials who run this country, as well as all other countries around the world. Now, Lord, we pray for three people who have sent in prayer requests to us here at Gospel Light Society. Lord, we pray for Roblin in Arizona. Give her relief from financial hardships even today. Bring better health to her husband, herself, and their son, Anthony. Show her mercy from those she owes. Give her peace in life and home. Lord, we pray this prayer for millions across this country and around this globe. Lord, we also pray for Lisa in Staniford, West Virginia. Heal their sick daughter even today. Lord, heal their daughter today, we pray. Lord, and we pray that you bless this family. Save every soul in these two families as well. Lord, we pray for Mary in Nairobi, Kenya. Give her peace of mind and grace. We pray that you would save her soul, save the soul of her family, and the souls of her family, rather. And Lord, we pray that you would fill them all with your Holy Spirit and the fruit of your Holy Spirit, which includes peace and joy. Holy Father God, we pray for the following people who have trusted you in their hearts recently. We pray, Lord, that you would confirm them in the faith, strengthen them in the faith, have them to grow in the faith, to become the strong Christians, the biblical Christians, the spirit-filled Christians that you want them to be. Lord, we pray specifically for Juan in Nicaragua, Lakeisha in Virginia, Portsmouth, Virginia, and Brenda in Arizona as well. We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you would encourage their hearts, help them to find a good Bible-believing church to attend where they are. Help us to be the disciples you want us to be. Now, Lord, we pray for the following people who have been saved for a while, but who have rededicated their lives to you. We rejoice with them in this decision, and we pray that they will keep their commitments to you and be strengthened in the faith. We pray specifically for Duabisi in Laos, Diana in Los Angeles, California, and Maya in Brazil. Lord, bless these dear saints and help them to grow in the faith. Help them to find a good Bible-believing church as well to grow in. In Jesus Christ's name we pray, and for his sake, amen. Now, dear friend, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ today as your Savior, please allow me to show you how you can get to know him today. All you have to do is believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died for you, that Jesus Christ died for your sins according to the Scriptures. and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures, and you will be saved. And like millions of others, you can come to know the risen Lord Jesus Christ for yourself. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." The Bible states in the book of Romans 10:9-13 that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, you shalt be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you are willing, dear friend, to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for your salvation, please pray with me the following simple prayer and mean it from your heart. Holy Father God, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad things in my life. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of all of my sins. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died for me, was buried, and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today and forever. Amen. Now, dear friend, if you just accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you just believed on him with your heart, and you prayed that prayer with me, and you meant it from your heart, I declare to you that based upon the scriptures, you are now saved from hell and you are on your way to heaven. Congratulations on doing the most important thing in life, and that is receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. For more information to help you grow in your newfound faith in Christ, go to GospelLightSociety.com and read what to do after you enter through the door. Until next time, my beloved, remember to pray, think, do. God bless you.